Things may not look too different the next time you visit the chimpanzee refuge in the fragile forest at the St. Louis Zoo, but behind the scenes, there's a major new addition, a brand new baby girl, born October 28th.
It's a very big deal for me. I've been here, this is my 16th year as an ape keeper here, and this will be my first actual chimpanzee baby. Being able to watch the other chimps interact with a newborn, it's just watching a baby grow up in this chimp family. It's gonna be a big deal.
The baby's father is Kijana. He's had offspring before, but this is his first at the St. Louis Zoo. However, this is the first baby for Mama Utamu, or Uti as she's known. So the zoo has been doing a lot of prep work with her to get her ready to be a mom.
We do a lot of training to kind of teach her to pick up objects so we can kind of say, Uti, pick up the baby, and we'll use a fake baby and she'll learn to pick it up just in case she doesn't want to pick it up. Sometimes those instincts aren't there, so we have to teach that to them kind of as a backup. We do think Uti is going to be a really good mom, but we want to have that backup just in case.
The training is done through positive reinforcement. The chimps learn to do tasks by being given rewards for certain behaviors.
They are very intelligent animals, and we like to do as much husbandry with them that we can without any medical intervention, anesthesia, things like that. So the more behaviors we can train with them voluntarily participating, the better it is for them, the better it is for us, the easier it is for us.
That training includes not only behavioral, but also medical tasks. In Utamu's case, that included teaching her to sit for an ultrasound and even how they determined she was pregnant.
Utamu is trained to urinate on command. So we give her the command and we come over with a syringe and we pull up some urine and we just do a typical pregnancy test just like humans take.
Seeing that positive result and the subsequent arrival of the yet unnamed baby is exciting not only at the St. Louis Zoo, but also for the chimpanzee population around the world.
We've got the WildCare Institute here at the St. Louis Zoo, and we've been involved in efforts in the Congo for a while now, and we actually recently this past year have turned that into a WildCare Center, and so it's the Center for the Conservation of Congo Apes. We're really concerned about the care of chimpanzees here at the zoo, as well as the care of chimpanzees in the wild. And so part of our efforts are for the conservation of the species. And so this is really exciting, not just for our chimp group, but for chimpanzees in the wild. Chimpanzees are endangered, so they have a lot of threats in the wild in terms of habitat loss. Basically, there's things like deforestation due to, let's say, forests being cut down, as well as mining. A mineral that's found in cell phones called coltan is actually mined in chimpanzee and gorilla habitat, and so that leads to deforestation. There is bushmeat trade is a problem for them, so there's lots of threats that they're facing.
Right now, Utamu and her baby are both doing well and resting comfortably. They'll stay in a private maternity area for some time to allow them to bond. Once they do, they'll stay together for as long as 10 years. And although they probably won't be making their public debut for several months, the hope is the excitement around the arrival of a new baby will help increase awareness of chimps and their habitats and help maintain a healthy population in zoos and in the wild.
The zoo is doing a lot for our conservation efforts over in Africa, and so this can kind of bring people in and kind of get people to connect more with the chimps and the chimp group, and get them to maybe connect what's happening, you know, over in Africa here. So it's going to be a good way to bring people in and a good way to connect people with chimps.
And there are things individuals can do to help with the conservation of chimpanzees.
There's a lot of the decisions that we can make here in St. Louis that affect chimpanzees in Africa. So recycling your cell phones, making sustainable choices in terms of palm oil, the wood you use. So really giving that chance to connect with people. Also supporting our conservation efforts through the WildCare Center, and having that healthy genetic population here in the United States is really important.